well. I came here to be distracted. And I was thoroughly distracted. What was that?
My favorite comedy of 2017.
Which, given the way 2017's going so far, it seems appropriate to be a horror movie. fucking hell. Neither of us have been having the best week. And yeah, I was really going to see this by myself because I was like, fuck it. I had a really shitty day yesterday. I just want to find something shitty to watch. I don't want to tear it to fucking shreds. And then the very last minute, I was like, fuck it, I'll come too.
Yeah. I was like, well, my plans got canceled, so thank God everyone got sick.
So let's go watch the Bye Bye Man. God damn, where do you even fucking start with this thing?
The fact that we have this year's Sofia Coppola.
Which one's who?
The actress. The one who played Sasha. The blonde girl?
Oh, yeah. I was thinking more Kristen Stewart, personally, but...
Oh, no, this was Sofia Coppola out of Godfather 3.
Oh, now I get the reference. Okay. I follow. I'm tired, man. My fucking luck lately. But anyway, no, this movie was ridiculous. Like, way more than I expected. Like, I knew it was gonna be bad, but goddamn. Like, all I could think of was watching this is like, I've seen better production value out of Emmanuel in Space.
What?
If you don't know what that is, don't look it up. But it was something that Community made a joke out of. It turns out it's a real thing. Don't
really
ask me why I know it's a real thing.
Don't think it, don't say it. Don't think it, don't say it.
Emmanuel in Space was a series of porn films back in like the 90s.
Okay! That had to have been a mess with everything floating around there.
I don't remember. My teenage years are kind of fuzzy.
Lay it on me! Where is it going?
The cum shots in particular were just all over the place.
Oh, you have no idea.
I know. Or do I? I don't know.
Oh, God, it's heading towards the boom bowl!
But actually, it actually was a joke using communities. Like, I was looking through Pierce's things. I found this thing called Emmanuel Space on Laserdisc. It's, I don't know what it is, but it sounds sexy. Laserdisc. A joke that maybe 5 people got. I was one of them going, ha! Ah! Anyway, but yeah, the Bye-Bye Man, I'm kind of flabbergasted in just how awful this fucking thing is. This is just pure dog shit. Just from the awful acting, just the god-awful cinematography and weird editing, just leads to just a mountain of unintentional hilarity.
And the weird faces.
And the weird face. Oh my God, like this looks like a high school like senior project.
Oh God.
It feels like a high school senior project. I feel like this is written by pretentious theater friends back in college.
Oh God, it's like, I couldn't even hold myself in theater.
You gotta get everyone else going in the theater too towards the end. Like you're start gonna join you and laugh. I'm like, my God, how can this get any dumber? Wait. It will find a way to get even dumber with some of the worst CGI I've seen since Birdemic. Oh my God.
Oh no, it's nowhere near that bad.
I didn't say as bad, I said the worst since. But even like some of the stuff on here is like, my God, who greenlit this? Who approved this? From the very first 5 seconds of the movie, it starts off with just this awful scene where you see nothing's more intimidating than an aging man in his 40s in a sweater vest with a shotgun.
No, and super glasses.
And super glasses.
It's like, not even holding brushes.
And it kicks down doors like they're made of fiberglass, like fucking cardboard, and just shoots all these people down. Most of them don't have bullet wounds.
Oh, yeah. Like, the one woman gets shot just, like, flies back in the wall and just leaves.
There's a dent on the wall, but there's no blood. There's no, like, there's no bullet wound. She just lying on the floor. Like, her clothes aren't even bloody. Like, I was like, did you just shoot her with a beanbag? What the fuck?
What was the part where she's just, like, throwing books at her? Go away! It's like, he has a fucking shotgun! No, or was it when he shoots two people in his house and those people are just like, huh? It's like staring from outside, like, you know what? No, you deserve to get shot.
Or better yet, like when he shoots down the door and one guy is just crawling, no reason. There's not a scratch on him. He's just crawling for no reason. And then he shoots him. Meanwhile, his wife, like the wife is downstairs and she's bleeding. So, you know, she got shot. Yeah. So what the fuck happened to the other guy? He's like,
legs were like, one of his legs was bleeding or something. I don't know.
No, I looked. There was no fucking blood on those pants.
Yeah, I'm not surprised.
It's like the latest fucking January movie I've seen in a long time. Yeah. I mean, goddamn. I mean, I've seen worse January movies doing this show, but my God, the level of laziness and incompetence here is astounding.
This is like the horror version of When the Bow Breaks.
Oh my God. No, but I laughed harder When the Bow Breaks.
I did too, but... Oh, God.
Oh, my fucking
Like, I mean, in
Christ.
Terms of production, no, this is still worse than When the Bow Breaks.
No. Like, at least the When the Bow Breaks had a competent cinematographer.
Yeah.
This one, again, it looks like porno. And, like, not, like 90s porno. Like, again, man with sweater vest, I see where this is going. But, my God. And just for the concept alone... This is such, like, it's hard to even figure out where to start and just how dumb and nonsensical everything that happens in this movie. Like, the one good thing I will give this movie is that Doug Jones looks kind of cool in the makeup.
He just looked like the thing from Prometheus.
I could see that, but I don't know, I kind of dug it a little bit. Like, okay, I was just looking for things to like at that point.
Yeah,
but...
I was like, okay, we got a bald guy in a hoodie. Okay.
Yeah, I mean, it's not the best in the world, but, you know, all things considered... Take what you can fucking get out of this piece of shit. I'm not touching you, Don.
Yeah, pretty much.
With this, like,
Don's phone home.
It's just like the worst, like the horror version of Shaggy and Scooby. Like, again, it's just so, like, for one thing, they go into this house, like, the homies by these three teenagers, like, the high school, like, college students, might as well be high school students, who are, like, so painfully trying to have chemistry with each other, and with, like this guy and his girlfriend and his black best friend, who is constantly hitting and grinding on his girlfriend. Which is like, dude, boundaries, fuck.
Yeah. Where it's like, or what was it? Yeah, it's like there's the one dancing, then after the other, he's just constantly thinking that he's like basically banging her. Like the awkward time where he's. We'll get to it later.
Was it the first hallucination or the one that came later?
Both of them!
So, yeah, we have this really awkward flashback where like the writer guy shoots a bunch of people. And then we cut to present day, where again three college students are moving into this crappy, like, I guess, fixer upper.
Yeah, we got Elliot played by Discount Charlie DeHaan.
I don't even know who that is.
Chronicle.
Oh, okay, yeah, I can see that.
Or The Cure for Wellness.
I'm curious about that one.
I feel like I've seen the black guy, the guy who played Jason.
What's his name? I don't even know. I probably from porn. I don't know. He looks like he did porn. I'm taking an educated guess. If this doesn't work out, he's probably going to go into porn. He doesn't have much else going for him.
Let me see. Honey Trap. What are these things? Between Two Worlds, Coco, Point One, Runaway, Scream Queen. Oh! I saw him in Scream Queens!
Oh, I didn't bother with that show.
That's actually a good show.
I tried it. I couldn't stand it.
Okay. That's when I stopped watching Supernatural.
Was that the one they tried again? That's crappy spinoff that never happened?
Yes! I think that's him!
Yeah, I know which one you're talking about.
Never mind. Then yeah, I did see that episode, probably.
It was very clear they're trying to set up a spinoff series that just wasn't happening.
Yeah.
But anyway, so these three move into this house, and they're all kind of douchebags in their own way, so you instantly just don't give a shit about them. Yeah. And then they have a party, and his brother looks like Alan Wake, which you point out to me, and I was like, fuck.
No, he was almost wearing the exact same thing. The only difference was his sweater wasn't tweed. But it's like, he had like the shirt with the hoodie and the jacket over it, the exact same haircut, the exact same face, just like, god damn it.
I always kind of thought Alan Wake was overrated, but that doesn't mean...
I will say the acting was about on par with this.
Yeah, and just as robotic. I remember, like, looking at the wife in Alan Wake for the first time and going, ah! Followed by just her going, it's a small world after all, it's... Do you remember that shit? It was scarier than the monsters.
Or wasn't that after the girl got possessed? How's it going, Mr. Wake?
At least I was trying to be scary. Like, the wife was trying to be sincere, but talk like this. Hi, honey. Ha, ha, ha. Ha, ha, ha. Like the puppet from Goosebumps. But anyway.
Yeah, so while they're there, they've...
Fucking Alan Wake's daughter comes in first, and she finds a coin on the ground, and she proceeds to put it on... By the way, I don't know who fucking built this house. Why are there like five tiny doors that go nowhere and serve no purpose?
I'm still laughing when she opened up the door the first time.
Yeah, I was gonna get to that.
And the dog comes out, just...
The dog's head comes out, like, but they do it like simultaneously, so as she goes in, the dog head pops up, like, like, ro-ro.
Yeah, all they think of was Scooby Dooby Doo, where are you?
Yeah, like, that's when the intermediate go, ro-ro,
right? Yeah, like, I wanted to see the Scooby Doo teachers, like, just like,
they're on Drish, Reggie.
Oh, they have like this 60s pop song playing, they're all just like going to the door.
Fucking spread. Hell, by the end, it might as well have. God damn it. And like those I don't even know what the point of those silver coins were even supposed to be. They're gold coins, but yeah. They were clearly like silver dollars. They painted gold poorly.
Yeah. Because that looked like the same tooth. That looked like the Two-Face coin.
Yeah, I know, because I have one.
Exactly.
I'm like, that's a fucking silver dollar, you lying bastards. Not even a good one.
Yeah. And the first time it wasn't even gold. It was silver.
Yeah, so I'm like, you guys really suck at your one fucking job. Whoever is the props manager.
I thought you were flipping them off. Does that look like you?
I'm not afraid to flip people off my show. I've done it all the time. I've done too many at times.
That is an awesome middle finger, by the way. epic!
The brightest middle finger reflecting off my pale white skin.
This fucking movie.
Me, Lolo Ho. Anyway.
So yeah, it was it
Spectacle Testicles while I was in watch.
So what, it was Elliot, Sasha, and Jason?
That was John?
John, there we go.
Yeah.
Show us a little we care.
Well, my notoriety with names being not what it is, being
You're
what
right,
it is.
It's John.
I'm surprised I actually remember that at all, to be honest.
Yeah.
It's only because I yelled it like five times. Mm. But anyway, while investigating, fucking douchebag McQueen goes in and finds, nightstand.
Yeah.
Like, one of the drawers has this thing, like, don't say it, don't think it. And in case he couldn't figure out the pattern the first time, because apparently he's not that smart, he feels the need to read the entire thing while rotating the drawer. Like, I feel like after the third time, you go, I'm pretty sure they all say the same thing.
Then, 2 hours later, don't think it, don't say it, don't think it, don't say it, don't, wow, I'm only halfway through this. Don't think it, don't say it, don't think it, don't say it.
Oh, it goes the other way this time. Don't think it, don't say it, don't think it. Oh, okay, cool. We found a reversal.
Wow, it can go backwards.
And meanwhile, inside, like, apparently that's a cover, so he rips that off and finds the word the Bye-Bye Man. And instead of instantly going, ha, that's a dumb name, and forgetting all about it, like, I feel like 99% of people in this movie would.
Yeah.
Like, in reality, he said, like, hey, I have this cool monster idea. You know what it is? It's called the Bye-Bye Man. It's like, shut the fuck up, John. No one cares what you think. Take your dumbass ideas and go out of there.
Yeah. It's like, just don't be scared. What I'd be scared of? The Bye-Bye Man.
Like, I feel like almost, like, one writer, I don't know how many people wrote this thing, was like, I think there's only one writer.
Like, there's only one guy.
Somebody was aware of how dumb this name was, because, like, the very first line in the movie is, like, did you tell anyone the name? Yeah, she thought it was funny. It's like, yeah, because that's a dumb fucking name.
Yeah.
Even, though, like, the poster advertising, like, tried to cash in on it, where it said, like, you won't be laughing when he sees you. I'm like, surprise, motherfucker!
It's like,
guess again!
Yeah. Ha! Doug Jones in makeup! It's like Hellboy!
I'd rather be watching Hellboy. Maybe not.
Oh, I'd rather much be watching. I liked Hellboy, and I really liked Hellboy 2.
I always liked Hellboy 1 better. I've always felt that the fantasy settings for Hellboy 2 didn't really work for me.
Fair enough.
It felt too Lord of the Ringsy.
Yeah, I will say this. I am still weirded out by the fact that Seth MacFarlane voiced the German fish tank guy.
Right. They just, I think, said yesterday, like, on the 19th, that Guillermo del Toro met with Ron Perlman.
Yeah. No, because Ron Perlman said yes. Oh, yeah, movie.
He's been wanting for a long time. It looks like it might actually be happening.
Yeah, because basically it's like, all right, I'm going to put up a poll on Twitter, and if we get to 100,000 views or 100,000 votes between yes and hell yes, we'll make the movie. I just voted. It's like, all right, hell yes!
I see what they did there. But anyway, that's a whole other topic. But,
it's one I wish we were talking about.
Yeah. So, meanwhile, again, this is where I feel like, this feels like a just rejected Stephen King book. Because, of course, the main character is a fucking writer. And there, of course, there's a goddamn psychic in the movie.
Wait, was he a writer?
Yeah, I think so, because he seemed like writing the beginning of the movie.
He was just writing something for a class.
I feel like they might... I don't know. I feel like they're implying that he was a writer of some kind.
Yeah, and he's just saying, she's like, dude, I thought of that shit in high school. Yeah, don't be so fucking proud.
You're not about
the ideas of reality and all that shit. Or, like, what was it,
Christopher Nolan put the book down.
No, one of the things I was a coin toss from God about the idea of fate. I was just like...
Okay, Two-Face.
Yeah, I was like, dude... I came up with that bullshit about how everything is 50-50, whether, like, either it happens or it doesn't, so don't think you're that fucking smart.
To be fair.
Knows I wasn't that.
To be fair, we all had the pretentious thought we were in college.
Yeah.
Especially when we think we're artists. And I will fully acknowledge I used to be this douchebag. Not to this degree, mind you, but a little bit. A little bit. I was full of myself. I still am, but I feel like I'm a little more aware of it. Not that it makes it okay, but I'm fully aware that I'm an asshole.
Okay.
Moving on.
Yeah.
I had a point there, and I lost it halfway through, and I think it's because I've been under a lot of stress lately.
Oh, it's all about you. When you said I. But yeah, no, seriously, that is an important thing.
I was saying, the channel is named after me. I'm a narcissistic prick. I thought we established this.
Yeah, many times.
So why is it a surprise to you?
I'm not. I'm just finally cracking.
Good.
The Mike man.
The Mike, god damn it. Someone make that poster. I'm going to go watch. I like
yeah,
that.
It's just a but. You just see, it was like, if you make a shitty movie, he's coming for you.
Fuck, I actually want someone to make that now. Make that a t-shirt.
Just like you pointing at the poster for an Adam Sandler movie.
Doing like the, what's the movie called? Invasion of the Body Snatcher face. I just want someone to take that picture and just post on something completely out of context. But anyway.
A good review for the Bye Bye Man.
Fuck. That actually kind of hurt. But anyway, after that, wacky shenanigans happen that just get increasingly bigger and dumber and more unintentionally hilarious to the point where we could not contain ourselves in that theater. And it was like everyone else was quiet. I just screamed, goes, ah! Like when the old lady then just spontaneously lights on fire. It's like, ah!
Or was it when the big black teacher gets ran, woman just gets ran over.
That was like even the other thing that I was going, okay.
Because basically what happens is, the whole thing is, if you say the name, then you start going crazy, then you'll probably want to start saying it to other people, and they'll start going blah, blah, blah. So anyway, he told his teacher, and she was just like, you know, basically just gone crazy.
In the librarian?
Talking very, yeah, I thought it was yeah, whatever. It doesn't matter, because this movie sucks. anyway, so... you know, talking the most, I've been seeing some weird things. He's like so nonchalant about it.
Have you got the impulse to murder people? Because I'm feeling it hardcore right now. You want to murder people together? Can I murder you? No, that's too far. Okay, can we compromise on murdering your friends?
Yeah. So anyway, she just killed her kid. So out of nowhere, just like... He discovered the secret, so I was like, not be afraid. Ooh.
I know, like, it was really that fucking hard to figure out. Like, I feel like just hearing the name, like, again, this whole movie would have just been, like, solved easily. If you look at the name and goes, that's fucking stupid. And you go on with your life.
Yeah, you know what made it easier? If the fucking psychic couldn't freak out.
Yeah. Again, why does this movie need a fucking psychic? That's why it feels like this feels like a script that even Stephen King said, nah, dude, that's really dumb.
Yeah.
And that's the man that made fucking Langoliers and Tommyknockers. This fucking hell.
Yeah. Speaking of which, let's talk about how this psychic person died.
Yeah.
And then we'll get to the other person we were talking about.
Oh, yeah. His greatest moment of his career. So as the movie goes forward, he's getting more, like, the douchebag McQueen is getting more and more suspicious of the bye-bye man and everything he's doing. Oh, no, I said it. I'm doomed.
Which also, after that, led to a fantastic Batman moment that was a missed opportunity.
Which part was it?
We'll get to it after this.
Okay. But anyway... So, he goes by to pick up Kim, who's a psychic, who did a seance, who heard the name, too, and she was a bad actress, too. Like, did you get any Blair Witch 2 vibes from her at all? Because I was feeling it pretty good.
That might explain a few things.
Because, like, this just reminded me of the goth girl from fucking Blair Witch 2.
Yeah.
I don't know if you got that vibe, too. I
forgot all about that piece of crap movie, too.
This just reminded me a lot of that movie, to be honest.
Yeah.
But anyway, so it picks her up, and they're driving back, and she's talking about how, like, Bye Man does this and that, and how she had to kill a roommate to, like, kill the cancer kind of thing of the name. And while they're driving, they pass by some railroad tracks, and she sees a family car, like, flipped over, and the family, like, on the side of the road, like, oh, no, we have to go stop and help them. And... they pull over, she runs out like an idiot, and...
Yeah. With a train coming by, and the guy just goes, no!
Because he's not in any other shot in that thing. He is, like, out of nowhere, like, you see a train cut, and then it just cuts to this guy whose head was not there before, just going, no! And it cuts back, and he's never seen again. Like, and I can think, all I can think of is that actor... on the soundstage going, this is the moment I've been waiting for. They're gonna sing songs and praises in my name. No! Cut to black. Mom, that was me! It's like when you play one of the animals in the nativity play when you're in church as a kid. When you're going, you do nothing, you contribute nothing, but your parents can see that you're there.
I'm a tree!
Doop, 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 I'm a stuffed animal tree.
And so, oh, she gets run over and, like, even show her bouncing around a little bit, so that got me a laugh.
God, man.
And then apparently he was chasing her down with a hammer, which, I don't know. It's like, where's the fucking hammer?
Actually, they did show that.
Oh, okay.
Because she had the hammer, like, the psychic had the
hammer. No, as in he had it in his hand.
Yeah, they showed him grabbing it and taking it with him.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Wait, really?
Yeah.
Why did that dumbass grab the hammer?
Because it's like, oh no, bloody hammer. Here, this is yours. Take it back. Yeah, it's like, here, I was saving this kitchen knife for you. Why are you running? Yeah. Would have been worse if he was yelling, going, why won't you love me?
It's kind of like, wasn't Family Guy the whole thing about, Lee Harvey Oswald being a bad shot?
I don't know.
It's like, Mr. President! Mr. President! Up here! I voted for you! Wait a minute. There's someone on the grassy knoll, and he's got a gun! Holy smokes, I gotta do something! All right, Lee, time to make yourself an American hero.
Like, what was one comedian I saw a long time ago where, so, like, I was on, like, we live in Country Hills, and one day, my wife or girlfriend was trying to say something from far away, like, trying to, like, wave at me from far away, but I couldn't see her from where I was, so I got my hunting rifle, and used the scope to look her down. Next thing you know, she's doing serpentines on the lawn. Zigzagging back and forth like, honey, it's okay. But anyway.
So after that, Carrie Ann Moss shows up. I laugh at that because what the fuck is Carrie Ann Moss doing in this movie?
Oh, she was in the trailer, so I knew she
was
coming.
Well, that shows how little I gave two shits about this movie.
Yeah, I knew she. I've seen this trailer enough times. I knew she was coming, so it didn't really surprise me when she showed up.
Yeah,
I was like, is this just some weird prequel to Jessica Jones? Maybe that's how she and Jessica know each other. Maybe she stopped the Bye Bye Man. I don't know. Like, here's my thinking: is like, why did no one ever try to shoot the Bye Bye Man?
I don't know.
That was one thing that's bugging me. Like, you have a gun. Why is that not? I mean, it probably won't work, but at least fucking try it.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know.
Note to self, the BBM is not affected by bullets.
Yeah.
Yeah. How do we?
Why didn't they just abbreviate it? Now that I think about it.
The big bowel movement?
Sure.
Or what I call them, the so long dude.
So long, dude. Slender Man's dumb brother. your dumb pet. Dumb, terribly CGI pet. I'm still laughing at how fucking awful that CGI was. I mean, laughably awful.
Yeah.
That, the production quality movie is so laughably...
It reminds me of a higher... Best way to describe it, it's kind of like a higher-end sci-fi channel movie.
Like, they couldn't even make like the green screen they use when he's driving a car look convincing. Like, nothing... There's just so many bizarre moments in this movie. Like, when he's... whatever, douchebag McQueen is driving down the road, and he's just hearing his song going, bye-bye, whatever the hell that damn
bye-bye, love.
Bye-bye, love, whatever the hell the song was, blasting at full volume, that comes out of nowhere, and she's like... What am I watching?
Because it has bye-bye in it! And it has to do with him fearing for his loved one having an affair.
And American Pie would not give them the right to the song, so they had to use something.
Oh, but yeah, what happened? The Batman moment. Oh, so after Psychic Girl gets killed, like, she's being grilled by the cops.
Mm-hmm.
And I love how he puts his hand very aggressively at a cop. He's just like, can I help you?
Oh, yeah.
But, it's like, you didn't tase him because he's white.
Now if the black man came over anyway.
Yeah. Yeah. Excuse me, I have a question.
Ah! Oh, man.
But anyway, what happened was, it's like, you can't say the name, okay? Swear to me. Swear to me. I just want to go, swear to me!
He could not have pulled that off. Well, kind of peeps be like, swear to me! I mean, I'm trying to sound not... Or like, because that guy could not act his way out of a paper fucking bag.
He still acted better than the girl.
Not by much. More like acting in the same bar, just in the other direction.
Yeah, this man was just like the wide-eyed face guy.
Well, like, especially when he has like the rant, like, he's supposed to get his big realization. He can't figure out what to do with his eyes. So, like, it keeps going from like, I don't know this, and then I guess, and then maybe I guess.
Yeah.
Anyway, I don't know why I sound like old man McGucket.
Yahoo!
Oh, God.
And so, yeah. He goes back to his place where girlfriend and best friend are flipping out. Also, kind of surprised the guy got himself untied.
Yeah, I was thinking that, too. It was like, so what exactly was the plan here? Get him in the basement and just leave him there?
Yeah.
Didn't lock the door, didn't do nothing, just left him there. That's after he hits him in the head with a baseball bat because he thinks he's fucking his girlfriend.
Oh, God, that scene was fucking hilarious. oh, yeah.
As they looked like, oh, yeah, yeah.
He just looked over his shoulder and... It's like, oh my God.
Or like that weird ass scene where like Karen,
Kim?
Carrie Ann Moss.
Oh yeah.
Is interrogating the three of them. And then Carrie Ann Moss just randomly winks at the black guy.
Yeah.
So he winks back. Like, I don't really know what to feel about this, but. It shooks at him like. Carrie Ann Moss looks just as confused as we are through her 5 minutes of screen time.
Yeah.
You know, they probably got her just so they could say somebody with star power in the fucking movie.
But they got the guy from Scream Queens in there.
I'm more thinking, like, you know, like, Carrie Ann Moss, you, like, do you have, like, an evening off anytime in the future? And she said, sure. That's how she ended up in this movie.
And she regretted it the whole way through.
Ah, she's got more successful things going on right now.
Yeah, she's like, she's also the only one that was actually doing a decent job acting in that movie.
Even though you could tell she stretched herself thin. Like, look, I'm trying, guys, but there's only so much I can do here. And it all leads to... Gosh, he finds out the writer's wife is still alive. She goes over there, and more wacky antics happen. As he thinks he's discovered, like, the weakness of the Bye-Bye Man, but he's like, oh, just don't find it scary.
Kind of okay. A little bit.
Which works for, like, a minute. And then she immediately goes, how could you figure it out and my husband couldn't? And then she just spontaneously lights on fire. Just out of nowhere, no reason, just... But nope, that was an illusion. Then a train comes, and then he runs over a librarian,
yeah,
who was just in the middle of the road for, yeah, no reason.
Yeah, just... And then she goes flying. The card is like flips and shit. Then he just walks over and she's like sitting by a tree. And it's like, what? Just,
tell Matt to swing away. Oh man, this movie was dumb.
Oh yeah.
Fucking hell.
Also, now you might know where you saw the main kid from.
What?
He was in Percy Jackson's Sea of Monsters.
Who was he in that movie?
Tyson?
Was he the fucking Cyclops?
I think he was.
Motherfucker! There's years of therapy gone out the window.
Oh,
fuck, I forgot about him. Oh, I'm gonna confirm this, because...
he was also in Terminator Genesis. Someone named Eric Thompson.
I don't remember that at all.
I don't know either. Oh, this is the best night ever.
Brought to you by A&O Burger.
Ow! I'm in pain! I am in physical pain! Okay, the Joker smile's gone. Okay, so finish up what just happened. He fucking kills his girlfriend. Black guy gets stabbed by girlfriend. Then he shoots himself because his brother and really dumb niece are there.
Motherfucking Tyson! God damn it! Motherfucking Jar Jar Binks, son of a bitch! Help us out, Dad! Like the fucking door of the God damn it!
I'm gonna break my teeth. God!
Fuck, I hated that character so much. Anyway.
So anyway, the Cyclops shoots himself in the head.
Don't call him that! The name of Tyson must be buried. Are you okay? Are you okay?
I was choking on spit.
Are you okay?
I'm good.
That's what you get, you son of a bitch.
It was worth it.
Close this tab forever. I don't want to see his fucking face. Fucking one eye.
Watch die! Watch die! Why? Die there! The die die.
Now, don't say it, don't think it. Much more threatening than fucking bye bye, man. Hi, Dad! You wanna go on an adventure? You're the best brother ever!
Oh, I need tea, my throat hurts. If it was fucking worth it! Oh, that revelation! Don't worry, Michael, he can't hurt you if you're not afraid of him.
I'm not afraid, I'm angry.
Ow. So anyway, yeah, fuck, I forgot the guy's name.
Fucking Tom. Tyson! Tyson!
Tyson shoots himself!
Tyson!
And
just brought back year one pain. Yeah. Just.
And the house catches on fire because apparently a lamp was on the bed.
I guess. Good as reason as any.
No, I saw it on the bed. I saw it smoking.
That's why.
It's like, wow, if only you gave that thing some attention. Oh, God, my throat.
Are you okay?
Oh, yes. I am more than okay. I am ecstatic. Because that just brought me so much joy. I'm so sorry you had to suffer through that. But God damn, that was funny. Dude, I think you got a stress lump in the back of your neck.
Not something unrelated, but,
anyway.
Well, thanks for drawing attention to that, asshole.
It's like, I think you just got a tumor.
Good, maybe you'll kill me faster. So I don't have to pay my car repair bills.
Yes, he died, your spirit just...
Flipping off every DMB and, like, every car dealership, every auto insurance company, and fucking Tyson. Tyson especially. I'll be the real bye-bye man. What? I won't terrorize him and kill people. I'll just be going, what were you thinking? How are these good? Why if you... Fuck you!
We're gonna make a super cut of this movie. In which case, it is actually you just saying, Tyson!
Tyson! Tyson!
Oh, yes! Oh, yeah, when he pokes his head, he's like, sees visions. He just sees visions of himself as Tyson. Just, no! Not them!
Tyson, remember!
We gotta do this.
I feel like Two-Face at the end of Dark Knight. We're like, you think I want to escape from this? There is no escape from this. Motherfucking Tyson.
Yeah. After all the freak out of
Tyson.
Also, yeah, of bad acting Tyson, Sasha seeing a naked black guy.
Yeah.
Just all that. Hey. Just
oh, yeah, like at the very beginning of the movie. Yeah. Like it just, she randomly turns around and she's like naked black guy and she goes, hey, baby, forget about him. Come with me. Like, this is our horror monster, everybody. This is what he makes people do. It makes people horny.
Apparently.
Okay.
Or see worms in psychic girls' hairs.
Sure.
So
and then you want to get the last, like, one of the closing lines in Weaver's film.
Oh, yes!
Or, like, Alan Wake is at the scene when his brother shoots himself to stop the Bible man from winning.
Before we do that, I want to point out something else. Why the fuck would Alan Wake take his daughter to a college kegger?
Honestly, I've seen it done before.
Yeah. I was just like, oh my God, you are a terrible parent. Or was it? When he's also talking about it, it's like, you gotta get your... He's like, I wish I had this. You gotta... I mean, the fact to do what you want, you gotta study. Wait, are you telling me to be responsible or be reckless? I am really confused here.
I don't know, man. This movie is confused.
Yeah. But anyway, so yeah, back to that. After his uncle and niece are there, and after he threw the cursed desk out into the creek or out in the woods, the daughter and the uncle are driving away, and she's like, What? He's like, she has these two coins, which I also forgot to mention. Remember the blinking eyes where the coins are floating? It's like, blink.
Oh, you remember how the wallpaper turns into
a dog face? I'm sorry, we're like so schizo, but this movie is like, what the fuck?
Yeah. But anyway, so they're driving away, and he's like, I found these in a little table that was by the creek. And he goes, I guess he wanted me to have, I guess Uncle whatever wanted me to have them. And he goes, like, what else is in the drawer? It's like, there was a bunch of writing in there. It's like, what'd the writing say? Oh, Daddy, you know I can't read in the dark.
What am I, a flashlight?
Like, it was such an obvious cue card in the background.
I'm just like, oh, oh my God.
That physically hurt. Not as much to find out Tyson's in this movie, but thanks for that, by the way.
Look how steamed up this car is.
To be fair, I did turn on the heater.
Even then, it's just like, I can tell, like, your rage is, like, steaming up the car.
Just what I fucking needed. By the way, if you would like
to help... Rest assured, Tyson got killed. He shot himself in the head.
By the way, if you'd like to help me get out of my crippling debt, please make sure to donate to the channel. Anything goes to help me get my life back on track. And deal with the inevitable insurance premiums.
Yeah.
Because apparently I forgot there was an accident back in April I completely forgot about.
Ooh, boy.
Yeah. That went on insurance.
So, oh.
Yeah. And my rates just went down. It'll be fine.
Yeah. Best of luck.
It'll be fine.
Yeah.
Like I said, like, the damage to my car is not even close to, the, like, my insurance deductible.
Yeah!
So, like, I, there's no, they have no reason to pay for it, so I think they'll honestly save me.
Yeah.
From, you know, getting worse consequences than it could be.
Yeah.
But anywho. So.
Yeah.
What was I talking about? Oh, so, yeah.
Yeah, cringeworthy lines. By the way, this movie had a lot of on-the-nose dialogue.
Oh, yeah, because I was expecting subtlety from a movie called The Bye-Bye Man.
Oh, I didn't expect... I was like, man, I knew it was going to be bad. Just...
Or like how this movie doesn't think you can read.
Yeah.
That's how dumb it thinks this, your audience is. Like, it's Barbara's in the library trying to find, look at the Bye-Bye Man, and it clearly says, like, oh, don't think it, found one case, and it shows the case on the screen, and in case you're too dumb to read it, he reads it out loud for no reason other than the audience can hear it.
Yep.
Oh, man.
So anyway, before they close, though, black guy actually survived. John, there we go.
Yeah.
Really, he's just the jock.
Yeah.
So that's it.
He's there to look pretty.
Yeah. So anyway, apparently he survived being burned to death in the upper floor. I don't know how.
The only horror movie the black guy makes it all the way to the very end.
Yeah. There's only one other one I can think of.
Which one?
Wrong Turn 2.
Okay, I never saw that one. So.
Yeah, it had the guy from it had the guy from Final Destination 3 in there. He was like one of the only two people to live.
Yeah, I never saw the Final Destination movies.
Okay.
But anyway,
he has a very interesting name. His name is Texas Battle. I'm not shitting you.
Is that the actor's name or the movie character?
That's the character. The actor's name.
Fucking hell! You know that was legally changed. Either that or his family was some serious rednecks, or both.
I'm not sure. But it's just
that's like naming your kids like, let's name our kids Steel Sword. Actually, kind of badass. Actually, like you know, every time he went to class in college, he's got horribly berated by every teacher. And like, all right, is Texas? All right, who the fuck wrote this?
Anyway, so John basically probably said the name to the cop.
Yeah, so it's like, oh man, you're being fucking optimistic. You think this is gonna get a sequel? It better fucking not, or I've lost all hope in humanity more than I already have.
Thankfully, this movie tanked, so that's not gonna be a problem.
No fucking shock.
I'm still shocked people showed up to watch this.
I know, we had like, what, four people walk out?
Of course, they were theater hoppers, but...
I'm pretty sure, like, one other person besides them.
Yeah! So five people.
Yep. All right, so you just want to move on to trailers.
Yes, please.
All right. So we got the trailer for John Wick Chapter 2.
Yay!
Yeah, that's going to be... I'm hoping that's going to be good.
Yeah, the first movie is such a fucking blast. I'm hoping this one can recapture that magic.
And of course, it has Martin Lawrence in there, too.
You mean Lawrence Fishburne?
Lawrence Fishburne. I don't... Where the fuck did I get Martin Lawrence?
I don't know.
I am so out of it. I had a Lawrence in there. That's where I got it. But anyway. And I still love him in Hannibal. That scene in season 3. Still a highlight.
Which one?
The one where he just... gets his revenge.
Oh, yeah. Just beats the shit out of him.
Yeah. It's like, that was an immensely satisfying scene.
Oh, God, yeah. He's like, oh, God, can't the good guys please just win for once?
Right. So then we got Rings. Eh. You like the first movie?
I like the original Japanese one.
Okay. I remember seeing the original American one when I was a kid, but... It's probably not aged well.
I remember I was like, I like the opening, I like the ending, the rest of it, eh.
Back when Blockbuster was a serious threat to horror.
Because I remember I was just like, this movie's not scary.
You were way more picky as a kid than I was.
Yeah. Like I said, horror, I think that was when horror just didn't really do much for me. Or maybe I just didn't like it because it was subtle horror.
See, I got freaked out very easily when I was a kid. It took me years to develop a backbone.
It depended on the movie. Like, I admit, some stupid things got me scared, but The Ring was just like, nothing's happening, and twist.
Okay, fair enough.
Because like I said, had a good beginning, had a good ending, but the rest of it was just like, eh.
Fair enough. And then we got Get Out. Which, that one looks weird.
Yeah, the Jordan Peele one.
Yeah, that one.
Where it's...
like, racist brainwashers, I guess, is the plot. I don't really know.
Also, I can't help but feel I saw the crazy guy from...
If you say he was Tyson, I swear to fucking Christ.
No. No, The Purge. Henry.
If he is, even better.
Let me see. I want to make sure I'm not, going crazy right now, because...
I didn't see him personally, so maybe you just know something I didn't, but...
Let me see. So, it was Henry, right?
I believe so. Something like that. Something like an
H. Oh, fucking A Verizon load. I guess. Yeah, that's probably him.
Yeah, that's him. I recognize those cheekbones anywhere. And survey says...
please look later. But anyway, so yeah, that movie just... I don't know what to think, because I like Jordan Peele, but at the same time, that movie just looks...
so weird.
Yeah.
It looks really weird. I feel like it's a me and Ron movie.
Yeah.
So maybe I'll try to talk him into go see it.
Because, the whole thing's basically all about, the fear of...
racism?
White supremacy, basically.
I guess. Good reason. I'll see if I can look it up. But anyway. So I don't know. That one looks kind of weird. Then we got the Resident Evil trailer, which this one got an intro, which is really? Of all movies? Yeah.
Where it's like, thank you for your patience. Guess what? I got a lot more spare. Of course, I'm going to be the one guy to watch. I'm going to be watching that one because I've seen them all.
Oh. Actually, I don't think... I think it's the one that's called Polite Leader. Is the one that was played the... Yep, it was Polite Leader.
Oh. Okay.
Not Henry.
Then who the hell is Henry?
I don't know. Maybe it's mislabeled. He is not in Get Out. So.
Well, damn.
I know. I'm disappointed, too. Then we got a trailer for Cure for Wellness, which I'm curious. That one looks interesting.
Yeah. Yeah, this is the first teaser trailer that came out.
Yeah, I've seen this a couple times. I'm curious. I'm curious where it's going, and I have no clue what the hell's going on, which is a refreshing change of pace in modern-day trailers.
Yeah.
And I like that actor.
Charlie Dahan.
Yeah, I like him. I think he can do good work when he's actually given a good script.
Yeah.
Then we got Kong, Skull Island. I am so fucking ready for that movie. I wasn't until I saw the TV spots, and I was like, fuck yeah. I am down for some monkey on weird giant skull monster action. And fucking Samuel Jackson.
And apparently John C. Reilly.
Well, yeah, John C. Reilly is playing John C. Reilly.
Yeah.
hi, I'm the only laugh you're going to get out of this movie, except maybe Sam Jackson tells a joke or two. Sam Jackson just have a pretty kind of a badass line in the TV spots.
Which one was that?
Where it's like, you better call in the cavalry. I am the cavalry. Right before he gets a giant fuck-off machine gun.
He's basically going to become the villain.
Oh, you know for sure he's going to be the villain in the movie. Yeah. They make it pretty clear in the TV spots where he's like, I will show him that man is king. Is another line he has in the TV spot. He's like, okay, I'm down. I'm good with this.
Yeah. It's like, at the same time, though, when your entire squad gets wiped out, I'm not entirely blaming him.
Yeah. At the same time, and the same teaser, I think. No, it wasn't that one. It was a different one. But it also shows Khan swinging a giant tree at a giant, like, monster. It's like, down, sold, yeah. You had me. All right.
It's like, this is what I wanted from Godzilla. More constantly, I mean.
Yeah, I was like, I still like Godzilla, but...
Yeah. Like I said, I know I'm in the minority for that one.
Well, it's like one of those things, like, I'm more of a hardcore Godzilla fan, so I was like, I don't know, if Godzilla barely being in the movie is a pretty common Godzilla trope.
Yeah, but even then, it's like...
No, I've seen people do comparisons. It's about average.
Yeah.
That's screen time for that Godzilla compared to
other
Godzilla
movies. That's what I've been told. But even that, for me, I think also just because those ones are a lot shorter, too.
Way more goofy.
That too, so you can have some fun out of it.
Then we got The Circle, which I don't buy the concept for this movie for a fucking second.
What if Apple was the NSA?
And I don't buy that, because, like, we freaked the fuck out over NSA. We would not open this with open, like, we would not welcome this with open arms.
Exactly. Now, if you see, we're going to update my info on Facebook. That's easily accessible.
Yeah, but there's a difference between that and public surveillance
24/7. That too.
Like, well, that's a big fucking line.
It's like, dude, we got cell phones. So we already do this shit.
Yeah. Well, at the same time, like, if I don't want someone to know on Facebook, I don't put it on Facebook.
Actually, people put everything on Facebook.
Well, those are morons.
Yep, there are a lot.
And yet, as we found out about NSA tracking things, we get upset when Facebook does faulty privacy settings. I can't protect my privacy. Now let me bitch about this on Facebook some more. It's like, no sense of irony. And we would not welcome this open hour. We'd be immediately skeptical. I don't buy it for a second. I don't care how much Tom Hanks is charming.
Yeah. My last one.
And then we got The Space Between Us, which I've talked about the trailer a million fucking times.
Yeah, so
which I just can't... That movie comes out in a couple weeks, finally, so I can stop seeing the fucking trailer.
Woo!
So yeah, what are you going to have final thoughts for the Bye Bye Man?
So stupid. So stupid.
Yeah.
At least it gave me some laughs.
Yeah. I'm just thinking about Tyson. How quickly it's starting to be Marlon Brando from Apocalypse Now. Years from now, it's like, Michael Creek! You've been sent by grocery clerks.
Yeah, you need to do one of your old-style reviews for that movie.
You know how much time that takes that I don't have anymore?
A lot. So you better learn to optimize it.
You want to edit? It's...
Yeah. I tried, okay?
And knowing me being a gigantic control freak, I would just go over like, you're doing it wrong. Get over. Move over. All right. I'm taking over.
Just like I planned.
God damn it, Grant. But, yeah, anyway, so... Yeah. That's a Bye-Bye Man.
Yeah.
I am kind of glad we saw it, though.
Yeah.
Then we got a few movies to catch up on. So I still got to see Triple X, which I'm looking forward to that one.
I'm looking forward to Split.
Split, which is doing good, apparently.
Yeah.
Although I haven't heard about... I managed to avoid hearing about the twist so far.
Same here. My guess is, like, the girls are probably just a part of his imagination. I have no idea.
And I've been told by people, like, if you guess this, twist, bravo. Well,
let's see.
That's what I've heard.
So he went back to his Sixth Sense / Unbreakable twist.
I don't know. Maybe. It's like, it's supposed to be really hard to predict from what I've been told. Kind of like The Prestige back when that came out.
Mm.
I don't think anyone got the twist back then either.
Yeah, I remember that one. That was a good twist.
Yeah.
I'm just convinced that this movie's twist ripped off Identity. That's all I'm gonna say.
Maybe. I don't know. Like, I have no idea what it is. I know it's probably like it's gonna be like the twist in Inception. It's gonna make it or break it for you. Not Inception. Yeah. Interstellar. Where, like, if you think it's dumb, you're 100% right. If you think it's good, you're 100% right. So, like, there is no right or wrong in that one. So, we'll find out what we say there this week. And then, what's it? Oh, The Founder. I want to see that one.
Yeah.
I'm down for my Keaton movie. I've been hearing some fantastic stories about what he's doing on the Amazing Spider-Man Spider-Man set.
Really?
He keeps making Batman quotes. It's like every time he blocks a punch, he looks at Spider-Man and goes, "I'm Batman." Or shit like that. So he's clearly just having a bunch of fun with it.
I want to meet him.
Right. But anyway, so that's all we got. It's getting late. I got to go home because I got to wake up at 6. So
good luck with that.
All right. See you guys later.
See ya.